One, two, three, four. Good morning. This is Jackie Weidenbinner bringing you the Holy Mass live from St. Mary Cathedral in Cape Girardeau, Missouri. Today is March 31st, Easter Sunday, the resurrection of our Lord. Our Mass reflection today comes from the Word Among Us daily meditations. Today is a day of great joy and celebration. That's because Jesus Christ, who suffered a cruel death and rose from his tomb, is now risen in glory. And now that you are raised with Christ, he invites you to enter into his joy. You may feel full of joy today, but what if you don't? What if you feel weighed down by the worries and burdens? There is still a way that you can experience Easter joy. How? By faith. As St. Paul writes in today's second reading, think of what is above. By faith you can recall that God loves you, that he is with you, and that he has won the victory over death and sin, including all of your own sins. Scripture promises that there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. That's you. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. That's you. Recalling these truths can lead you into another experience of Easter joy, the joy of serving the Lord and his people. Peter must have been overjoyed when Jesus told him, "Feed my lambs." His failures and sins, even his denial of the Lord, had been washed away. Now he could participate in the mission of the risen Christ. As you serve Jesus today, by loving others, by sharing your faith, or by joyfully preparing a family meal, believe that, just like Peter, you are also participating in Jesus' mission. And that is a true and certain path to joy. Easter joy is not just about gathering for Mass or enjoying a feast or wearing a special outfit. You know that. It comes about through faith and service, and it can last all year long. So set your heart on what is above today. Then hear Jesus say, "Come and share in my joy. Jesus, I rejoice in your resurrection." Our celebrant for the Mass this morning is Father Alan Saunders, the pastor of St. Mary Cathedral. Our musician today is Miss Leanne Hendricks, and our cantor is Miss Lisa Simmons, who will now lead us in song.
Good morning. Happy Easter. Please rise and turn off your electronic devices. Alleluia, Christ is risen. Give glory to God. Let us join with all believers in jubilant praise and join in our opening hymn, Jesus Christ is Risen Today, number 281.
Jesus Christ is risen today, alleluia, a triumphant holy day, alleluia. Who did once upon the cross, alleluia,
in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let's We gather on this happy day, we rejoice in the resurrection of our Lord, and also in his willingness to forgive as he suffered the cross for the salvation of all. So let us call to mind our sins with confidence in his mercy. Lord Jesus, you are our risen Savior. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the Alpha and the Omega of our faith. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are a conqueror of sin and death. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who on this day through your only begotten Son have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Our first and second readings today will be read by Mr. Dan Williams.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ your life appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please join in singing the sequence, which can be found on number 284.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you. A garden, a tree in the middle, a man who is a gardener, a mother, or a woman who was a mother, a great sleep, an open side, a Sabbath rest on the seventh day, the first day of the week, a breath of life, a new creation. As we hear that list, we might start to think about the book of Genesis, the first book of the Bible. Many of us would recognize those as details from the story of the creation of the world, and in particular, Adam and Eve. You have the Garden of Eden. You have the tree in the middle, the tree of for the knowledge of good and evil. We have Adam, who is given the job as gardener of the Garden of Eden, and you have the woman whom Adam would call Eve because she's mother of all the living. A great sleep that God put Adam in so that he could take a rib from his open side to create Eve. A Sabbath rest on the seventh day, where God, after 6 days of hard work, rested on the seventh day. The first day of the week, as God created his world anew. A breath of life, which gave life to Adam and then to Eve. A new creation, something that had never happened before. And as we think about those details of the story of Genesis, we also might be familiar with the fact that all of these details belong to St. John's Gospel. As we celebrated the last 3 days, Holy Thursday night, Good Friday, Easter Vigil last night, and now Easter Sunday, all of these details belong to the Easter story, beginning with the Last Supper in the upper room and coming to the empty grave as we hear the proclamation by the angels of our Lord's resurrection. St. John tells us that in the place where our Lord was crucified, there was a garden. Jesus was crucified on a tree in the middle of two thieves. St. John makes it clear, not just between, but in the middle, using the very words of the book of Genesis. Jesus is mistaken by Mary Magdalene in the scene following today's in the gospel as a gardener. Thinking he was a gardener, she asked him, "Have you misplaced the body?" And so Renaissance painters in their description of the Easter scene will have Jesus in a floppy hat as if he's trying to keep the sun off himself, and he's holding a hoe or some kind of garden tool, maybe to throw off Mary as she recognizes him when she takes a good hard look at him, just now in her grief not being able to see him. A deep sleep as our Lord dies on the cross. An open side, as the lance of the soldier pierces our Lord's heart and blood and water flow out, providing us now with new life in Christ through baptism and the Eucharist. A Sabbath rest on the seventh day. Our Lord finished his work after Good Friday and lay in the tomb resting until he would come again in his resurrection, body and soul. A breath of life. As on Easter Sunday night, St. John tells us, our Lord in his first encounter with all of the apostles would breathe on them and say, "Receive the Holy Spirit." Then 50 days later, the sound of a loud wind would fill Jerusalem and the upper room with the apostles, Our Lady, and about 120 members of the nascent church. A new creation. Our Lord, in fact, has recreated the world in his resurrection. As we celebrate today, we're celebrating a new scene of Genesis, a new creation. Last evening, four new members here at St. Mary's and hundreds others in southern Missouri and thousands, if not tens of thousands, throughout the United States and the world became a new creation through baptism. That grace was sealed into them by confirmation, and all of us who have those gifts now can call on them in this Easter celebration. Not just one day, but 50 days of celebration, allowing the Holy Spirit stirred up within us to be able to do his work for the salvation of the world. And as they received their first Holy Communion, they completed their initiation. Each and every one of us has that opportunity today. If we need to wait for Holy Communion, because we know we should be making a good confession beforehand, we have that grace available all week long, this week, and next week on Divine Mercy Sunday for about 2 hours at Old St. Vincent's. The grace flows during this Easter season. So if you know you need to wait for communion, be confident in the mercy of God, make that good confession, and then hurry back to the communion line. But if in the state of grace, strengthen your faith, your trust, and your hope in the mercy of God. All of us, a new creation in Christ. The four that were baptized last night, and each and every one of us in this celebration has an opportunity to remember the details not only of the book of Genesis at the beginning of the creation of the world, but now on Easter Sunday, its recreation. A garden, a tree in the middle, a man who was a gardener, a woman who was the mother of all the living, a great sleep, an open side, a Sabbath rest on the seventh day, the first day of the week, a breath of life, a new creation. Please rise. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we renounce Satan and his works and promise to serve God in his holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is seated now at the right hand of the Father. You believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. And now may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us the forgiveness of sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Asking God for fidelity to these promises, let us offer our petitions.
That our Holy Father, Pope Francis, will inspire renewed Easter faith and encourage Christ-based love for the poor of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of nations ensure to every person the free exercise of religion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the newly baptized and newly received continue their lifelong journey into the Paschal mystery, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those crushed by addiction, depression, and grief rise to new life through the grace and mercy of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the living body of Christ gathered here nourish the spirits of those who have received the Easter sacraments, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We remember Paul and Gary Oliver, for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For family and friends who have died, especially for Bill Jones, husband of Joan, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For peace in all the troubled spots of the world, Haiti, the Holy Land, the Congo, and for the Ukraine. We pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this most holy season. Help us to make the best of it for your glory and our salvation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Please join in singing our offertory hymn, The Strife is O'er, number 289.
The strife is o'er, the battle.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy. To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, and on the Catholic and apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants and all who are gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you the sacrifice of praise that they offered for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you also for those to whom you have been pleased to give a new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands. With eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
Father Alan now shows the body of Christ to the assembly and then kneels in adoration.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. Once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Father Alan now shows the cup of Christ's blood to the assembly and then kneels in adoration.
The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar and high in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing. Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Offer to each other some sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As the congregation prepares to receive the body and blood of Christ from the altar, we invite you at home to join us in a prayer of spiritual communion. Jesus, my Savior and my God, I desire to receive you in Holy Communion, and since I cannot receive you now in the sacrament, I ask you to come to me spiritually and to refresh my soul with your goodness. Come to me and never let me be separated from you. You have said, "Come to me all who are weary and heavy laden, and I will refresh you." Please come and refresh me now. Jesus, may all that is you flow into me. May your body and blood be my food and drink. May your passion and death be my strength of life. Jesus, with you by my side, enough has been given. May the shelter I seek be the shadow of your cross. Let me not run from the love which you offer. Hold me safe from the forces of evil. On each of my struggles, shed your light and your love. Keep calling to me until that day comes, when with your saints I may praise you forever. Help me to be faithful to you in every way that I may praise you forever in heaven. Amen.
To the Lord of life, who was broken to bear. Let us raise our voices to the cross of Christ, where the earth and heaven unite. God has wed creation on the tree of hope, where the darkness becomes our light. Let us join in the dance of heaven and earth. Give thanks for the goodness of God. Let us ever glory in the cross of Christ and the triumph of God's great love.
Please join in singing Seed Scattered and Sown, number 400.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our parish is putting together a photo and recipe book this year, so we invite all of you to please take your family picture. This weekend is a perfect opportunity for you to do that. And please send it in to us along with your favorite recipe so we can make this a wonderful parish book. The deadline is April 30th, and you can find information in the bulletin on where to send your picture and your recipe. And our recessional hymn will be Alleluia, Alleluia, number 296, which is not the number that's up here. I'm sorry, it's 284. I'll get it right. Number 284 will be 281. I'll get one of them right, sorry.
Next Sunday, we'll be celebrating Divine Mercy Sunday, and there'll be a service at Old St. Vincent from 2 to 4 with opportunity for confessions, Divine Mercy devotions, benediction, and then veneration of the image of the Divine Mercy. So we encourage your participation. As it is a fifth Sunday, we're offering a blessing to expecting parents and their unborn children. If you'd like to receive that blessing, remain after Mass, and after I finish greeting, just come up to the front and we'll offer that blessing to all who'd like to receive it. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.